Here we go, folks. We're talking to Justin Dunk about Canadian quarterbacks now. Nathan Rourke was officially made the number two QB of the BC Lions this past week, while Michael O'Connor continues to push for the same role with the Calgary Stampeders. Dunkster, are we entering the golden age of the Canadian quarterback?
It's certainly possible, and Rourke set the goal, Hodge, to start a game in 2021. Now, if you're Michael Riley, hopefully that doesn't happen because it likely means you're out injured. But the fact that Rourke is adjusting his goals on the fly shows you that he's smart and intelligent, and he's always working to get to that next step or that next level. Very prolific at Ohio University for the CFL fans who are uninitiated in terms of Rourke. We've talked about him and covered his career, literally going all the way back from when he moved from Oakville to go to Alabama and play at an elite high school program there. He actually ended up having to go to junior college because he didn't get the NCAA offer he wanted coming out of high school in Alabama, and ends up going to Ohio University and has a stellar career there. The Bobcats love him in Athens, Ohio. All the people there do as well. So the fact that I think the Lions are looking at him outside of his passport and not just being a Canadian, but being the best number two quarterback they could have speaks volumes. But also the fact that he is Canadian does mean something. And you mentioned Michael O'Connor as well. I do think as we go along here, and we're seeing it in the NCAA, in the NFL, and even the CFL, that skill position players, I know you hate the term, Hodge, but skill position players, and especially the quarterbacks, are becoming more prevalent, whether it's at the U Sports level, NCAA, and then hopefully that translates for quarterbacks at the CFL and NFL levels very soon.
Yeah, I was in on media availabilities with both of these guys this past week, and both played down the Canadian quarterback angle. Both made it clear they're proud to be Canadian. They're not ashamed to be Canadian. I don't know anybody who is, to be quite honest, but I still think that, you know, the fact that they are Canadian is relevant. The fact that they are Canadian does make a difference to young kids sitting at home wondering, hey, can I play in the CFL? Oh, I guess I can't because I'm not going to be 6'5 and 300 pounds and playing along the offensive line, right? No, you can play in the CFL at any position. You can go out there and be a quarterback. You could be a star receiver. You could rush the passer. And in Edmonton, they're probably going to start two Canadian defensive ends this year, which I don't think any CFL team has done in the last decade. So, you know, I think it's wonderful that we're seeing this change come about. We're also having this conversation on Russ Jackson's birthday, the GOAT of Canadian quarterbacks, and arguably, you know, players ever in the CFL, which is remarkable. But I'm very excited to see what these two guys do. They are both 100% legitimate prospects. They're not in camp because they're Canadian. They're there because they're great quarterbacks. Nathan Rourke, a little undersized. I know the NFL is probably more accepting of smaller quarterbacks than they've ever been before, but he's still about 6'1", a little over 200 pounds, you know, almost more of a you know, receiver DB type body than necessarily a quarterback type body. So I think that's one of the reasons why he's in the CFL. And man, I hope, and I'm obviously not hoping that Michael Riley, as you mentioned, gets hurt. I'm hoping Michael Riley stays healthy, but man, it would be great to see Rourke even just in short yardage or a package specifically designed for him. I think that would be sensational.
Yeah, I would imagine the Lions are going to want to limit the hits on Riley overall. That was a big issue in 2019, obviously, but that's probably why Rourke is going to see that short yardage package really become his. And there are not too many better quarterbacks currently to learn from than a guy like Michael Riley. You know, Bo Levi Mitchell might be another one, but really, other than that, in the league, those are guys that are multiple MOP winners, have won multiple Grey Cups. I'm talking about combined together. So the fact that Rourke gets to learn from Riley and O'Connor gets to learn from Bo Levi Mitchell could really help them in the future. As you said, we don't want to see Rourke start because Riley gets injured. But in a year or two from now, we want to see Rourke and O'Connor be at the point where they're being viewed by other franchises as legitimate starters and being signed. And maybe there's the quarterback carousel that happens to the quarterback needy teams. And that's where they get the opportunity, not because of injury.